What's up, everybody? Isaac here with Civil Engineering Academy. Hey, we're in 2022. Can you believe it? The year is already here. And today I want to impart with you the top tips to help you ace the civil PE exam in 2022, because we are headed to a CBT exam this year and I want to make sure you are ready and prepared for it. So I'm going to share with you the top tips to help you ace the civil PE exam in 2022. It's coming right up. All right, the very first tip that I have for you is to become intimately familiar with the specifications that the NCEES hands out to you. If you grab a download of that, you'll see that they don't break up the exam anymore into AM and PM pieces anymore. It's all one specification with a mishmash of problems. Now, if you look through all the specifications, they still do have an AM type of section because they're the same problems among all the other specifications. And the only difference is the depth exam. If you look at the specifications, the depth topics for your particular depth topic does change among the specifications. But they did get rid of the designation between AM and PM. So what does this mean to you? It means that they can, with a new CBT exam, mix and match. What does this mean to you on these exams? It means you can mix and match. If I can talk, mix and match problems on the CBT exam, which is, you know, a different thing, a different take. The paper-based exam was a clear delineation between AM and PM on their problems. Now they can ask you them pretty much in any order. I don't see why they couldn't. This is a benefit to them addressing these problems and throwing them at you with a computer-based exam. How are you going to tackle that? You're going to do it the same way you did when it was paper-based. You're going to go through and tackle these problems as they come to you. And if they're easier, you're gonna blow through them quickly. If they're harder, you wanna flag them and come back to them later down the line so you're not wasting time, which brings me to another tip, and that is also time management. Time management is still key on this exam. We work with a lot of students in our courses, the Ultimate Civil FE Review course and the Ultimate Civil PE Review course.com, and they always bring up time management as a big hurdle for people to get over these exams and a real key to help passing. I've talked to people that have had to guess on the last 15 questions, and that's just unacceptable, really, because it will kill you and your results. So you want to make sure that you're not guessing on the last 15 problems or so on the exam. And so how do you do this? How do you manage your time better? The way that you can do this is by taking practice exams. And I recommend at least taking two, one that is more breadth related to those kind of problems, and one that is depth related, that is difficult problems related to your own depth section. And in doing this, you want to set up a real testing environment. This means blocking out time in your day, whether it's a weekend. I usually recommend when you're preparing for this exam, you're going to need 2 to 3 hours a day and more hours on the weekend, like 6 hours on a weekend. We'll chunk out a time in that weekend to take a practice exam. And it doesn't matter if you break it down into only taking, let's say, 20 questions and timing yourself for, say, 2 hours to get through it. It doesn't matter how you break that up so you have the time to do it. But you need to give yourself the pressure of taking the exam well before you go into the real exam and sit down and take that thing. So time management is always key. Make sure you're practicing exams and making sure you're giving yourself pressure in a testing environment at your own home and at your own pace. So that is another key takeaway as you prepare for this exam in 2022. All right, another piece of the puzzle and a tip that you're gonna need to understand really well is the new reference handbook. Now, the new reference handbook just came out for the CBT exam. And a lot of people are expressing frustration with it because it does not have a lot of content related to your depth exam. And I understand that. And I can see that it's very frustrating when you're preparing and you're comparing that to the Civil Engineering Reference Manual, which is also still a great reference manual for preparing for the PE exam. And if you want that, go use our link at civilengineeringacademy.com/PPI. You'll save a little bit of money and you'll get some good resources there. But you can still use the CIRM to help you prepare, but you definitely need to understand the PE reference handbook, because that's gonna be the only book at your disposal, that and the codes that they will give you. It is a searchable PDF that you'll have on the left side of your screen, whatever side's left, and the problem will be on the right, and you'll be able to search this thing, but it does not have every piece of content that you might study or prepare for. And so a lot of students are expressing some frustrations with that handbook, wondering if NCEES might ask anything outside of that. And frankly, I think they can if they want to, right? But for the most part, I think they're going to try to stick to that handbook. And if they don't, they will list what is in the question itself. They'll be giving you the information within that question itself. So understand that, understand what that handbook is, what's in it, how to use the equations in there, where they're at, what graphs and tables are in there to help you on this journey to pass. And then take a ton of practice problems and use that book right along with you to help you on this journey to pass. So definitely get familiar with that handbook. It's a real key to passing this exam, as it's the only tool now to help you on this. Gone are the days of the suitcase full of books that everyone would bring in as you go into the exam, and everything's computer-based. So just a bunch of PDFs that you can search, and that's gonna be it. All right, another tip I have for you is that there are gonna be plenty of theory or conceptual type questions that they're gonna be asking you. These can be very wordy and people get hung up on them sometimes because they're asking engineering questions that you're just gonna have to reason out. So how do you understand these type of problems? How do you get better at solving them? And the only way around that is as you practice problems, you really need to understand the concepts that they are asking you. Why did they, you know, as you're going through the solution, why did they select the question that they used? How is that broken down? Is there another equation that they could have used to solve the same thing? You know, all of those things can be bundled up to help you understand and conceptualize the concept and the problem that they're asking you. And as you really understand the problem, if they do throw some of these wordy conceptual theory type questions at you, you'll be able to reason those out in your head because you've really studied the problem really well and understand it. That's really the only true way to get through this. Now, many people in the past had, it was open book. You could go look through a book and try to study a concept real quick, but that's all gone now as we've gone to CBT exam. So to truly understand these concepts, you're gonna have to really study the problems really well, understand why they've selected the equations and how maybe those equations break down so that you understand the concepts better. And that's really the way that you're gonna do that. And don't be surprised that there will be a lot of problems like this on there. In the past, it's always been, you know, 12 to 15 problems in the morning and the same for the afternoon. So you're looking at almost 30 questions on the exam that will be this way. So don't be surprised by that. You know, go in as you're studying, understanding that, and really try to understand the concepts of the problems, and you'll be way ahead of the game. All right, the last tip that I have for you to ace this exam in 2022, and that is to get the right resources. I run civilengineeringacademy.com, and we offer a ton of resources there. We also have a ton of free resources, which is on our YouTube channel. But if you were looking to up your game, we have practice problems, practice exams. We also have a full-blown review course. Go check it out at civilpereviewcourse.com. Many people have taken it, many love it, and I can share tons of testimonials with you as well. And our success rates are great. So go check those tools out. We've built those for you. And as a guy in the trenches, as a practicing engineer, I can tell you that it's fun to have been there and done that, and now to try to help you do the same thing, because our goal is to help you on your own journey to become a professional civil engineer. And I can't wait till you do that. So go check out civilengineeringacademy.com. Go check out the review courses. If you need practice exams, they're all there too. And we're excited for what's coming in 2022 as well. So thanks for being here. Those are the tips we have for you. I hope those have been helpful. If you've liked this video, give it a like, subscribe to us if you're just finding out about us. But we are here to help you on your journey to ace these exams. Can't wait till you become a professional engineer in 2022. Stay tuned and we'll see you in the next one. Bye. Becoming a PE in 2022. You can do it. See ya. Sorry.